children, take out your geography book. Today's topic is crust or the lithosphere. The word lithosphere has been taken from a Greek word, lithos meaning rock. The outer layers of the earth's structure is about 6 to 48 kilometers thick and consists of two layers, Sial and Sima. Sial consists of solid or continental parts of the earth crust. They are composed of many kinds of rocks which have the density and composition of granite. This granite layer is often called Sial because of the predominance of silica and aluminium in its composition. The granite layer or Sial floats on Sima. Sima, the lower continuous layer, it has an average density and composition similar to that of common black volcanic lava called basalt. This basaltic layer directly lies under the ocean floor and here forms the thinnest part of the earth crust. Its continental areas, the granitic and basaltic layers together, can reach a thickness of approximately 45 to 48 kilometers. The density of Sial is lower than Sima. The crust on the whole is thickest beneath the mountain and thinnest under the ocean. It is composed of various kinds of rocks. Its uppermost part consists of sedimentary rock. This sedimentary layer is not continuous over the entire surface of the earth and is usually thin. The thickness of the sedimentary rocks varies from 3.2 to 32 km in the areas of folded mountains. Thus, the granitic layers consist of mostly continent and basaltic layers of ocean form the upper layer of the earth called the crust. However, Sial is a discontinuous layer floating over the continuous layer of Sima. The contact zone of the crust and mantle is called a Mohorovic discontinuity after the Yugoslav scientist who discovered it. Mantle, our second layer, mantle is a layer between the crust and the core with its upper boundary marked by the Mohorovic discontinuity and its lower boundary by the Gutenberg discontinuity. The depth of mantle varies between 35 to 2900 km. The density ranges from 3.3 at the Moho discontinuity to 3.7 at the Gutenberg discontinuity. This layer is composed of magnesium and iron silicates along with substantial quantities of sulfides in the upper mantle and nickel and iron in the lower mantle. Thus, the mantle is divided into two parts. A, the upper mantle or asthenosphere. B, the lower mantle or mesosphere. The lower part of asthenosphere, like mesosphere, is solid, but the upper part of asthenosphere is in partial molten state. The velocity of the earth wave decreases in the asthenosphere and it is therefore referred to as low velocity zones. Barosphere or core. Barosphere or core consists of two layers, core and inner core. Core, the central part of the earth, is known as core. It consists of a dense nickel iron alloy with a temperature estimated to be about 2700 degrees Celsius. The outer perimeter of the core commences at the Gutenberg discontinuity at 2900 km from the surface, where this outer core exists in molten form. The inner core with a radius of 1400 km is believed to consist of knife but is forced into a solid state by increased pressure 3 million tons greater at the center of the earth than at the surface. The density of this layer ranges from 14.5 to 16. Temperature also increases sharply with descent into earth until it may reach at least 4000 degrees Celsius. And with this, I am ending my today's class. Goodbye.